Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're reading Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and we're hearing about Narada Muni. He's searching for the person who receives the greatest blessings, the greatest mercy from Lord Krishna.
我们正在聆听的这部书叫《大伯教堂甘露》，Narada Muni呢正在寻找，到底是谁得到了主Krishna最大的祝福、最大的仁慈？
So Narada Muni had gone to the higher planets. He'd gone to heaven and he met Indra, but Indra sent him to Brahma, and then Brahma sent him to Lord Shiva.
Narada 就去了高等星系，去了天堂，在那里见到Indra，Indra呢又把他派遣到了 Brahma 那里，然后之后 Brahma 呢又把他差遣到了主 Shiva 那里。
And Lord Shiva has sent him to Vaikuntha. He told him the people in Vaikuntha, they have the greatest mercy of Krishna. So we're hearing about the nature of Vaikuntha.
我们将要聆听的是有关于Vaikuntha无忧星系的本质。So
Vaikuntha devotees, they always relish pastimes, pleasure pastimes in the company of the Lord.
Vaikuntha的居民总是在主的陪伴下享受着主的逍遥时光。So
because they can always be in the company of the Lord, devotees prefer to live there.
由于Vaikuntha的居民可以与至尊主为伴，所以他们宁愿就居住在Vaikuntha。We
may wonder what is so good about Vaikuntha.
我们可能纳闷，想要了解那Vaikuntha到底好在哪里呀？
Because devotees on earth, they must be equally as good as the people in Vaikuntha. The devotees of Lord Vishnu on the earth planet, they must be just as good as the Vaikuntha Vasis.
Okay, okay. The
pure devotees on this planet, they enjoy devotional service. It's only in Vaikuntha that they can enjoy the company of the Lord personally. They can enjoy the Lord along with His goddess of fortune, and they can have wonderful, endless varieties of pastimes.
And
it's only in Vaikuntha you can have that, not on earth.
那么这种享受呢，只有在Vaikuntha才可以品尝到，在地球上享受不到。And
also in Vaikuntha, there's no anxiety. You don't feel the anxiety of you don't feel any anxiety about not tasting devotional ras. You're having so much ras with Krishna. So there's no anxiety that you're missing something.
And when
the Lord the Lord of Vaikuntha, sometimes he will momentarily disappear from the vision of the devotees of Vaikuntha. So when he disappears, just for a moment, that increases the desire of the devotees. They become more eager to be with him than ever.
一旦奉献，一旦至尊主短暂的从奉献者的视域当中消失的时候，奉献者就更渴望与至尊主在一起。
Yeah, in Vaikuntha, when the Lord disappears from the devotees become more conscious. It increases their thought of the Lord, and they become even more eager to enjoy rasa with him.
那么至尊主这种短暂的消失，就使得奉献者们他们更渴望、更有知觉，他们对主的思念就增强了，他们更渴望享受到和至尊主之间的交流。
So, Lord Shiva says, that is why I say the residents of Vaikuntha are greater than everyone else.
主Shiva说，正是由这个原因，我才说。 瓦昆塔的居民们比其他的任何人都要了不起和伟大。
They're getting the special mercy of Lord Krishna. They're his very most beloved devotees.
他们正在得到主 Krishna 的特殊的仁慈，他们是主的钟爱的奉献者们。
The devotees in Vaikuntha are greater than even liberated Vaishnavas who may be here in the material world.
在瓦昆塔的居民奉献者们，甚至比在这个世界上那些已经获得解脱了的人们更加伟大。And
Lord Shiva counts himself as one of those liberated Vaishnavas in the material world.
主Shiva把自己也划入到在这个世界当中已经解脱了的Vaishnava行列当中。So
Lord Shiva is arguing that Lord Vishnu gives the most favor to these people living in Vaikuntha.
So,
Lord Shiva says they must be his dearest devotees.
主Shiva说的，他们一定是主最钟爱的奉献者了。So,
Parvati, Lord Shiva's wife, is also there, and she says, she has something to say, and she says that among them all, the goddess of fortune, Sri, is famous.
这时候主Shiva的妻子Parvati开始说话了，她说，在他们就是Vaikuntha的居民当中呢，幸运女神Sri是所有的主的奉献当中。
Yeah, and she's very dear to the Lord, and she's the goddess of Vaikuntha and all of its residents.
她是主最亲爱的人，她也是Vaikuntha的居民当中的幸运女神。
So Lord Shiva's consort, Parvati Devi, she is a partial expansion of Lord Vishnu's consort Sri.
主Shiva的伴侣，Parvati是主Vishnu的伴侣Sri的部分扩展。So
Parvati had been hearing Lord Shiva glorify the people who live in Vaikuntha, but he had never mentioned anything about the Queen of Vaikuntha.
Parvati呢，在旁边一直在聆听她的丈夫。 赞扬瓦昆塔的居民，但是她的丈夫并没有提到瓦昆塔的皇后。So
Parvati was disturbed by this, and so she took the opportunity to say something.
为此，Parvati感到有一点不安，所以她就借机就开始说话。
So everybody knows that the goddess Sri, she is the beloved wife of Lord Vishnu.
众所周知，幸运女神 Sri 是主 Vishnu 的最亲爱的妻子。
And one of her names is Hari Priya.
她的其中一个名字叫做 Hari Priya.
And she is always worshipped with great reverence by all the Vaikuntha people.
所有 Vaikuntha 的人们都怀着敬畏之情才崇拜她。
So to support this claim that Lord Vishnu's consort Sri is the most favored devotee, Parvati will now describe the greatness of the goddess Sri in more detail.
为了支持他这个论点，说主 Vishnu 的伴侣是所有这个奉献当中至尊主最亲爱的，所以现在他就要 Parvati 将要详细的来简述这一点。
And Parvati says the goddess Sri's mercy expands wherever she throws her glance. Whatever she looks on, she gives her mercy.
Parvati 说，无论幸运女 Sri 她把目光投向哪里，那么她的仁慈便扩展到那里。
So the rulers of the different planets, they get their power and their knowledge and their detachment and their devotion from her.
不同星系的各个统治者们，只有透过她才能得到各自的力量、知识、气节和奉爱之心。
According to Mother Parvati, the demigods are powerful only by the blessing of the goddess Sri.
根据 Parvati 母亲的观点，半神人们只是由于幸运女神 Sri 的祝福才变得如此强大有力。
And it's thanks to the goddess Sri that the demigods properly understand the positions of the Supreme Lord and the living entities.
而且也正是由于 Sri 的原因，半神人们才得以正确的理解至尊主的地位以及生物体的地位。
And because they understand that, they give up their interest in material enjoyment, and they give up their interest in liberation, and they become devotees of the Supreme Lord.
正是由于这个原因，这些半神们才得以放弃他们对于物质享受的兴趣，已经对于解脱的兴趣，并且他们成为了至尊主的奉献者。
And to support this, there's a statement by Durvasa Muni to Indra. And Durvasa Muni is talking to Indra in the Vishnu Purana. It's described that where there is patience and opulence, then where there is patience, then opulence comes. And patience also follows opulence.
在 Vishnu 往事书当中呢 ，Durvasa Muni 这样对 天帝 Indra 说道：“无论哪里有耐心，哪里就会有富裕，而耐心又会尾随着富裕而来。”
But if somebody is not favored by the goddess Sri, then they will not have patience, and without patience, they will not have any good qualities.
但是没有谁要是得不到幸运女神 Sri 的恩宠，她便没有培养不起耐心这项品质，而没有耐心，他们又如何拥有良好的品质呢？
So in the Vishnu Purana, Lord Indra also offers prayers to Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune.
在 Vishnu 往事书当中呢，天帝 Indra 也向幸运女神献上如下的祈祷。
And she, Lord Indra says to her, he said, Oh, goddess, you personify mystic knowledge of sacrifice, of material nature, and of the secrets of devotional service, and of perfection for the soul.
对 ，Indra 祈祷道。 幸运女神呐、啊，您是献祭的玄秘知识，是物质自然，是奉献服务的奥秘，以及是灵魂的完美境界的化身。
And he said, "You are the giver of ultimate liberation."
您是终极解脱的赐予者。
Ultimate liberation is pure devotional service.
终极的解脱就是奉爱服务。
And that pure devotional service is, that's a property of the consort of the Supreme Person. And it's only gained by a fortunate soul, only when this Goddess of Fortune recommends that soul to the Supreme Lord.
而这种终极的而这种奉爱服务是由于是由至尊主的伴侣他给予的，只有当幸运女神把这个灵魂介绍给至尊主的时候，这位幸运的灵魂才得以获得奉爱服务。
The goddess of fortune can ignore people like you, Parvati speaking to Lord Shiva.She can ignore people like, or maybe she's speaking to Narada Muni, ignoring people like you who worship her with great respect. And she promises to undergo severe penances to worship the Supreme Lord, even though he was not taking much interest in her.
帕瓦提又接着对 Shiva， 也许是对 Narada 这样说道：“他就是幸运女神，他忽视了像你这样怀着巨大的敬意崇拜他的人。他幸运女神发誓要经历严酷的苦修来崇拜他自己亲爱的主，即便他的主对他是并不理睬他。
Only devotional service can attract the attention.”Of the goddess of fortune Lakshmi.
只有奉爱服务才能吸引到幸运女神 Lakshmi 的注意力。
And Lakshmi worships Lord Narayan with pure devotion.
而 Lakshmi 是怀着纯粹的奉爱崇拜主 Narayan 呢。
And she willingly accepts any difficulties and any menial service just to please Lord.Narayan.
幸运女神心甘情愿地来接受任何困难，还有从事任何卑微的服务来取悦主 Narayan.
Actually, Lord Narayan he's always satisfied in himself. He doesn't need anyone's help to fulfill his desires. He's self-satisfied.
事实上主 Narayan 呢是自我满足的人，他并不需要任何其他人的帮助来实现自己的心愿。
So there are many devotees Vaishnavas and they look to Mother Lakshmi's example of perfect surrender and they want to follow in her footsteps.
有许许多多的 Vaishnava 们都仰慕母亲 Lakshmi 的完美的臣服的榜样，并且希望能追随她的步伐。
An example of this are the wives of the Kaliya snake, how they prayed to Krishna.
这个的例子就是卡利亚蛇的那些妻子们，她们向主 Krishna 祈祷。
Yeah, the wives of the Kaliya snake prayed to Krishna that we don't know how this serpent Kaliya.Has got this great opportunity of having the dust of your lotus feet on his head.
卡利亚蛇的妻子们向主祈祷说：“主啊，我们不知道这个卡利亚蛇曾经做过什么，他得到了如此大的好运，得以被你的莲花族的尘土所触碰。”
Just to try to get that.Dust of the lotus feet of the Lord, the goddess of fortune did austerities for hundreds of years and gave up all other desires and took great austerities and vows.
只是为了得到主至尊主莲花族的尘土，幸运女神便从事上百年的从事了严酷的苦修，放弃了所有其他的欲望，并且接受了严格的誓言。
So the goddess of fortune, the supreme goddess of fortune is called Mahalakshmi, and she's the eternal beloved of the Lord of Vaikuntha.
这高无上的幸运女神被称为是 Mahalakshmi, 她是 Vaikuntha 之主的永恒的最亲爱的伴侣。
But she doesn't have to worship the Lord of Vaikuntha to get him.
但是他无需来崇拜主外坤特之主来得到他。
But she has expansions. Her expansions, they will come as avatars to accompany the different incarnations of Lord Narayan.
但是他的不同的扩展会以各种各样的化身 avatar 来降临于世，来陪伴着主 Narayan 的各式各样的化身。
So some of the avatars of Mahalakshmi are the daughters of Bhrigu Muni.
其中的一些 Mahalakshmi 的化身是成为了 Bhrigu Muni 的女儿。
They're described in the Vedic scriptures as doing penances in order to get the Lord.As their husband.
在伟达文献当中描述说，他们从事了严苛的苦修来得到主作为自己的丈夫。
So Parvati continues, she said, "This the most perfect chaste wives, they reside forever on the beautiful chest of the Lord and follow Him in all His incarnations."
Parvati 又继续说，在所有贞洁妻子当中的最完美的人，她永恒地居住在她的丈夫的美丽的胸膛上，并且无论她的丈夫以何种化身显现，她都追随着她。
So one of Mahalakshmi's expansions is the Lakshmi who controls and gives.Opulences in the material world.
Mahalakshmi 的其中的一位扩展是那位在就是在这个控制着这个物质世界的富裕，并且分派物质世界富裕的那一位 Lakshmi.
And people who want to get Lakshmi's grace like this, they want to get money, opulence.So they know from their experience that this Lakshmi is restless. She doesn't stay in one place for very long.
那些寻求得到就是 Lakshmi 的仁慈，也就是想得到财富的钱财富裕的人，他们都有切身的体验，就是 Lakshmi 她是不安不稳的，她不会恒常的留在一个地方。
But the original Lakshmi is not like this. She's very steady in her devotion to Lord Narayan.
但是那一位原初的 Lakshmi 并没有这样的天性，她稳定地处在主 Narayan 的奉爱服务当中。
She always stays in the company of Lord Narayan, and she resides on his chest and follows him.Wherever he goes,
他总是陪伴在 Narayan 的左右，就居住在他的胸膛，并且无论主去哪里，他都陪伴着主。
So just as the Lord of the Universe, the Lord of the Universe is Janardhan, and he is the God of Gods. He comes to this world.So when he comes to this world, that time his helpmate who comes with him is the goddess Shri.
正像宇宙之主，众神之神卷纳丹，当他降临世界的时候，他的帮手，他的助手，姓女神 Shri 也一同降临。
And when the Lord appears as a demigod, then she will also come as a goddess. And when he becomes a human, she will also become a human woman.
当主显现为一位半神人，他也显现为一位女半神人。而当主显现为一个人类的形体，他便也显现为一个女人的形体。
So she will accept a body exactly corresponding to whatever body Lord Vishnu assumes.
无论 Vishnu 显现为何种化身，他也会相应的显现为相应的化身。
So hearing all of this, Narada is very attracted and he's inspired. He wants to go to Vaikuntha.
听到这一番话，那儿的母女非常受到激励，也很想去维昆塔了。
So Parvati says to him, she said, then the sage, his mind vibrating with the sage was so in so much ecstasy, he called out, "Glories to you, O husband of the goddess Kamala." O Hari, Lord of Vaikuntha. So this was the ecstasy, the ecstatic calling of the sage.
Shri Parikshit 继续说道，接下来这位圣人就在狂喜当中，高呼道，所有荣耀归于你，幸运女神卡玛拉的丈夫 Hari 啊，Vaikuntha 的主人呐。他就这样在狂喜当中呼唤着。
O Vaikuntha world, all glories to you, glories to all who live there.
Vaikuntha 世界呀，所有荣耀归于你，所有荣耀归于那里的居民们。
O Padma, Lord Krishna's beloved, O presiding goddess of Vaikuntha.
Padma, Krishna, 最亲爱的人呐、Vaikuntha 的主宰女神呐、
So Narada had heard Lord Shiva and Parvati describe about Vaikuntha and glorify the people there, and then also they glorified the goddess of fortune. So Narada was overwhelmed with ecstasy hearing all this.
那儿的呢就听到了主 Shiva 和 Parvati 描述了 Vaikuntha 的荣耀，并且描述了他的居民的荣耀，以及幸运女神的荣耀。那儿的听到这些了，他感到极度的狂喜。
So although the Supreme Lord was actually present on earth in Dwarka, but Narada forgot about this and he wanted to go at once to Vaikuntha.
尽管至尊之人呢目前正在居住在地球上的多尔卡，纳尔达却忘记了这一点，他希望立刻就去外昆塔。
So he praised Lord Narayan and his kingdom and his residence, and he praised the greatest devotee of Vaikuntha, Mahalakshmi.
纳尔达便赞扬了主 Narayan 呢，又赞扬了外昆塔的居民，然后他就打算启程就去Vaikuntha了。
So one, he wanted to go to Vaikuntha and personally offer respects to the goddess of fortune.
那儿的希望能够拜访Vaikuntha，亲自向幸运女神献上顶礼。
So Narada he stood up and he was getting ready to go, but Lord Shiva stopped him, and Lord Shiva took him by the hand.And he's going to speak to him.
Narada 就起身准备离开，然后主 Shiva 呢就用手抓住他，阻止了他。主 Shiva 想就对他说话。
So from the words Narada was speaking, due to the words Narada. Okay, you gotta mute. You gotta mute these other people.
Sorry, 为了防止 Nara 的怀疑说幸运女神 Mahalakshmi 已经和 Shri Krishna 一同显现了，主 Shiva 便提醒 Nara 的说，Rukmini 已经显现为 Bishmaka 的女儿。
Am I muted? Can you hear me?
Hare Krishna.
I got muted with everybody else, so I had to unmute myself.
Sorry.
All right, so... Narada Muni may say that Mahalakshmi never leaves the sight of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan.
Nada 也许会说，Shri Mahalakshmi 从来不离开至尊性格神手的左右。
So Lord Shiva responds to this by saying that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
主 Shiva 就回应这一点说 ，Krishna 是至尊性格神手。
Krishna is the original.The source of all, the origin of all origins.
Krishna 是源头，是所有的源头的源头。
So we may wonder why is Lakshmi sometimes seen in the company of incarnations of the Lord, just like Lord Vamanadev and the thousand-headed Mahapurusha and Lord Kapila Dev.
We may wonder.为什么幸运女神有的时候会看到幸运女神陪伴在像 Vamanadev 主的 Vamanadev 化身的身旁，或者是牵头的 Mahapurusha 的身边，或者是 Kapila Dev 的身边
？So these Lakshmis who accompany these avatars, these are avatars of Mahalakshmi, but the original goddess of fortune, who is the dearest devotee of the Lord of Vaikuntha.She is gone to Dwarka as Queen Rukmini.
而这些 Lakshmi 呢，他们只是最原初的 Lakshmi 的扩展，而原初的 Lakshmi 呢，他是 Vaikuntha 之主最亲爱的奉献者，他现在呢已经降临到了 Dwarka， 成为了 Dwarka 的皇后 Rukmini.
Rukmini is the perfect and complete divine consort of the personality of Godhead.And she always serves at Krishna's lotus feet.
Rukmini 是性格神手最完美的神圣的伴侣，她总是服务着 Shri Krishna 的莲花足。
And because Lord Krishna is not a mere incarnation of Vishnu, but he's the source of all incarnations.
主 Krishna 并不是 Vishnu 的一位，仅仅是 Vishnu 的一个化身，他是所有化身的源泉。
And the same way, Rukmini is also supreme. She is the source of all the goddesses of fortune.
以同样方式 ，Rukmini 也是至高无上的至尊的，她是所有幸运女神的源头。
So Lord Shiva says to Narada Muni, he said, just sit down and I shall whisper in your ear a very big secret. Please hear me with confidence.
主 Shiva 对 Narada 说，现在请你坐下来，我现在将要向你透露你一个最秘密的秘密，请你仔细的聆听。
So because original personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, and his original consort, Rukmini, have appeared on earth, Narada has to put aside, there's no need for him to go to run off to Vaikuntha.
那既然呢，原初的人格守神和他原初的伴侣现在已经显现在地球上了， Narada 就放弃了他渴望跑到瓦昆特的愿望。
And he should sit down and hear what Lord Shiva has to say.
他应当坐下来听主 Shiva 说什么。
And Narada, he shouldn't just go running to Dwarka without first listening to Lord Shiva's advice.
而且 Narada 呢，也不应该首，不应当马上立刻就跑到 Dwarka， 而不首先听一下主 Shiva 的机密的建议。
And what Lord Shiva is going to say, it should not be heard by everyone, not even by the personal associates of Lord Shiva.
并且主 Shiva 希望所说的话呢，不应当是不应当是每个人都听到的，甚至他的亲生的朋友也不应该听见。
And Lord Shiva is going to whisper it into the ear of Narada Muni.
主 Shiva 将在 Narada Muni 的耳边轻声的向他耳语。
Because he knows that, he may say something which is not very pleasing to Parvati.Because Parvati is a very dear friend of Mahalakshmi.
因为主 Shiva 呢不想让 Parvati 不高兴，因为 Parvati 是 Mahalakshmi 的一个密友，亲密朋友。
So Lord Shiva says to Narada Muni, "There's a greater recipient of Krishna's mercy than your father, Brahma, and there's somebody greater than me, and there's."And there's somebody greater than all the servants like Garuda and even the goddess of fortune.
主 Shiva 说比起你的父亲 Narada 以及我还有像 Garuda 这样的其他的仆人甚至是幸运女神本人有还有一个主 Krishna 还有一个人得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
So this person's name is Prahlada, and he's famous throughout the world as the dearmost devotee of Krishna.
这个人的名字就是 Prahlada, 他闻名遐迩，他是主 Krishna 最亲爱的奉献者。
So Lord Shiva is telling Narada Muni that don't think that you can fulfill all your desires just by going to Dwarka.
主 Shiva 对 Narada 说你不要指望现在就去拜访 Dwarka 就能实现你的所有的心愿。
Now there's a devotee in this world even greater than the goddess of fortune, and that is Prahlad.
在这个世界上有一位奉献者他甚至比至高无上的幸运女神还要了不起。
So、before,
那个人就是 Prahlada。
Before you go anywhere else, you should go to visit him.
在你去其他拜访其他地方之前，你应当首先去拜访这个人。
Prahlad has so much devotion to the Supreme Lord that he is very dear to the Lord.
Prahlad 对至尊主怀着如此的奉爱之情，以至于至尊主对他。非常的钟爱。
He's greater than all the Lord's servants in Vaikuntha, including Garuda and Vishwakshina and even Lakshmi.
他比起Vaikuntha主的所有的仆人，包括 Garuda 在内，以及 Vishwakshina 还有 Lakshmi 在内，他对主的程度都要更加亲切。
And Lord Shiva says to Narada Muni, I hope you didn't forget the Lord's words, what the Lord Krishna spoke about this.
主 Shiva 对 Narada Muni 说，我希望你没有忘记，至尊主对在这一点上所说的话，亲口说的话。
You must have read about them in the Puranas, then you should remember also the verse, this verse.I will speak the verse.
您一定在往事书普兰纳当中曾经读到过至尊主的话， 我现在呢，就会提醒你他所说的这个师姐。
So Lord Shiva speaks this verse. He says, without saintly persons for whom I am the only destination, I do not desire to enjoy my transcendental bliss or my supreme opulence.
这个师姐是这样的，没有那对于那些，就是我是他们唯一目的地的圣人们，如果没有这些这样的圣人们陪伴，我不渴望享受超然的极乐，也不渴望享受我至高无上的富裕。
So this verse is spoken by the Supreme Lord to Durvasa Muni in the ninth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam.
这个师节是至尊主在圣典薄伽瓦坛第九篇当中对 Durvasa Muni 所说的话。
So this verse shows the greatness of the Vaishnavas.
这个师节就表示了 Vaishnava 的伟大。
That even Krishna gets transcendental satisfaction from his pure devotees on earth and elsewhere, but he does not get much attraction from his own consorts in Vaikuntha.
甚至 Krishna 本人也从他在地球上以及其他地方的纯粹奉献者那里得到巨大的满足，而这种满足呢，他。甚至没有从 Vaikuntha 他自己的伴侣身上得到。
Yeah, he doesn't get so much pleasure from his own consorts in Vaikuntha, or from the opulence, the great opulence which the goddess of fortune gives him for his pleasure. It doesn't give him as much pleasure as he gets from pure devotees.
至尊主从他的纯粹奉献者身上所获得的快乐和满足，是他的性在 Vaikuntha 的伴侣，以及 Vaikuntha 的伴侣为了他的快乐创造的那些富裕所得到的满足都无法比拟的。
And he's not so much attracted by his own beauty either. The beauty of the, although the Lord is all attractive, his own beauty doesn't attract him as much as the pure devotees.
虽然至尊主的美是无与伦比的，但是他自己的美，对他的吸引程度也比不上他的纯粹奉献者对他的吸引程度更大。
And the Lord himself told Durvasa Muni, he said, I am completely under the control of my devotees.
主对Durvasa Muni说，我彻头彻尾的处在我的奉献者的控制之下。
I am not at all independent.
我根本就不是独立的。
Because my devotees, they have no material desires. So I sit only in the core of their hearts.
由于我的奉献者们没有丝毫物质欲望，所以我就坐在他们内心深处。
And the Lord says, what to speak, he said, not what to speak of my devotees, even the devotees of my devotees are very dear to me.
Sanatana Satana Goswami 说，由于 Krishna 一想到他的纯粹奉献者的荣耀，他就处在狂喜当中，所以主 Krishna 他他就说到了我的奉献者，他所以他无意当中脱口而出说你乌的吧，他本来是要说我的奉献者。
So we have to understand that the Lord's form, the personal form of the Supreme Lord is the source of all the demigods, and that includes also Lord Shiva, and that gives great pleasure to his devotees.
Lord Krishna, 个人形体是所有半神，包括主 Shiva 在内的源头，他给了他奉献者以快乐。
But the Lord, the Supreme Lord, he considers his own body worthless compared to the value of his devotees.
但是主认为，比起他的奉献者的价值，那他甚至他自己的身体也没有那么珍贵。
So how great are the devotees of the Lord?
所以主的奉献者们是多么的了不起和伟大呀。
The demigods like Lord Shiva and Brahma and Indra all come from the creator of the universe, the Supreme Lord, in his form as the Mahapurush.
以 Shiva, Brahma 和 Indra 为首的半神人们都源于至尊主的 Mahapurusha 化身。这位宇宙的创造者，他们都来源于 Mahapurusha 的。
The Mahapurush is a direct expansion of Lord Narayana.
Mahapurusha 是主 Narayana 的直接扩展。
And Narayana himself is the shelter of all the created and non-created beings.
Narayana 本人是所有受造的生物以及没有被创造的生物的庇护所。
So his form is definitely superior to all the different forms of the demigods.
所以他的形体要比所有半神的形体更加高级。
And the beauty of the Lord gives pleasure to all of his servants like Shesha and Garuda, and they enjoy taking part in pastimes with the Lord.
主的英俊相貌给予像 Shesha 和 Garuda 这样的仆人以快乐，他们非常愿意参与到主的消时光。
So the opulence and the sweetness of the form of the Lord.Cannot be completely described in words.
主的形象的富裕和甜美是无法用语言彻底的来描述的。
But in the opinion of the Supreme Lord, his own opulence and sweetness are nothing compared to the greatness of his pure devotees.
然而根据真主本人的观点，他的富裕和他自身的甜美甚至都跟他纯粹奉献者的伟大都无法比拟。
So it's very difficult to properly glorify the pure devotees.
所以要恰当的荣耀纯粹奉献者这非常困难。
And among all those devotees, Prahlad,stands out as the example of perfection.
在所有这些纯粹奉献者们当中 ，Prahlad 是所有完美的体现和榜样。
So the good fortune of Prahlad is inconceivable.
Prahlad 的幸运简直是不可思议。
Prahlad is one of the very rare Vaishnavas described.Who has no trace of material desire.
Prahlad 是在前面描述过的世界当中的 罕见的 Vaishnava 之一，他们没有一丝一毫的物质动机。
So the Lord appreciates these pure devotees more than he appreciates his own self.
主欣赏这样的纯粹奉献者的程度，甚至超过了他对自己的欣赏。
And of course, he appreciates the pure devotee much more than he appreciates Brahma and the other demigods.
并且他欣赏奉献纯粹奉献的程度超过了对 Brahma 和其他半神的欣赏程度。
And Prahlad is completely surrendered to the Lord.
Prahlad 彻底地臣服了至尊主。
And his position is superior to that of pure devotees. Even pure devotees like Shesha and Garuda are not on the same level as a devotee like Prahlad.
像 Shesha 以及 Garuda 这样的纯粹奉献者的层面都比不上 Prahlad 的层面。
So Prahlad is very special among the Vaishnavas. The Lord has said about Prahlad that those who follow the example of Prahlad will naturally become pure devotees.
所以 Prahlad 是在 Vaishnava 当中也是独一无二的。主这样说呢，这样描述 Prahlad 说，那些追随你的榜样的人，他们自然而然的也会成为我的纯粹奉献者了。
And Prahlad is the best example of Krishna's devotees, and everyone should follow in his footsteps.
Prahlad 是 Krishna 奉献者当中的最优秀的榜样，每一个人都应该追随 Prahlad 的步伐。
So we'll stop there today.
我们今天早上的正课讲到这里，接下来我们来看一下问题。第一个问题是来自于上周四Jayagovind 的 David Dasi 的问题，感谢 Guru 甜美的甘露，为什么佛陀没有像马哈帕布那样直接把圣名告诉普通大众呢？为什么不直接向人揭示 Krishna 的崇高地位？这样做是不是给如今的奉献者们在传播 Krishna 直觉的道路上造成了一定的困扰和阻碍呢？导致那么多人只追随佛陀而不臣服于 Krishna？ 谢谢 Guru。Thank you Guru for sweet nectar. Why Lord Buddha is not Why Lord Buddha does not taught the holy name to the people in general, like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why Lord Buddha didn't reveal Lord Krishna's
Because the people in the time of Lord Buddha were all atheistic and very sinful people. They had no taste for the holy name.
就因为在主佛陀的时代的人们都是无神论者。他们罪恶深重，他们对于品味，他对圣名没有丝毫品味。
They were killing animals. They were very sinful people. They could not chant the holy name.
他们杀戮动物，以至于他们就是罪行累累，他们根本就没办法唱诵圣名。
So Lord Buddha had to trick them.
所以佛陀不得不来欺骗他们。
Somehow they had devotion, they surrendered, they had faith in Lord Buddha, and they followed Lord Buddha.
无论如何呢，他们对于佛陀就有一些奉爱之情，并且他们追随了佛陀。
So he didn't speak to them about God, and he didn't speak to them about the soul. He just said, you should find out.
所以佛陀就对这些无神论者说，没有提到神，也没提到灵魂，他们就佛陀就告诉他们，你们去寻找就好了。
So Lord Buddha, according to the time and circumstances, he had to think how to help these people, how to bring them to a higher level of consciousness.
所以佛陀呢，他就根据当时的时间还有环境，他想方设法的怎么帮助这些人，把他们带到一个更高的知觉层面上。
So, they developed faith in Lord Buddha. They somehow they had faith in him. They trusted him, and they followed him.
所以这些人呢，他们就对佛陀就有了信心，就信任佛陀，从而追随了佛陀。
So they didn't chant the holy name of the Lord, but they chanted the name of a devotee of the Lord. They chanted the name of Amitabha Buddha, right? They chanted Omitofo, Omitofo. They chanted like that. They couldn't chant the holy name, but they could just chant this Omitofo.
So these people, they didn't chant the holy name, they just chanted Omitofo.
So, just like the one time there was a hunter, he couldn't chant the name Rama. He couldn't chant the name Rama because he was a hunter, he was a very sinful person. So they told him, okay, chant Mara, Mara. Mara means death. And so what he chanted, well, he liked that, he liked to chant the name Mara. He thought, yeah, this is nice. He would chant Mara, Mara, Mara. But he was chanting Mara, 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 and became Rama, 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 Rama. He reversed.
就从前有一位猎人，那么因为他是猎人呢，所以他没办法唱诵主的圣名。然后最后有一个圣人就告诉他，你应该念 Mara，Mara 的意思是死亡。反正这猎人特别喜欢这个词儿，他就不停的念。Mara, Mara, 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 最后就念成这个 Rama。
So, people were chanting other things. One day they will chant Hare Krishna by the mercy of a devotee.
所以无论如何呢，这些人他们也念诵了一些名字。那么迟早有一天，急着奉献者的仁慈，他们也会唱诵圣名。
Yes。
下一个问题是，魏丽，对所有人顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的莲花组，没有得到 Guru 的仁慈，很难在灵性上进步。请问怎样才能取得 Guru 的仁慈呢？
Well, when you follow the instructions of the Guru, then you get the mercy of the Guru.
您是通过追随 Guru 的训示来得到 Guru 的仁慈。
You have to follow the teachings. That's the real mercy of the Guru. When you follow all the instructions.
您需要追随 Guru, 听从 Guru 的教导，并且追随 Guru 的训示。
So all of the instructions, not just the four regulative principles and 16 rounds, you have to follow all the instructions.
这不仅仅就是这些训示，不仅仅指的是，遵守四项基本原则，念诵十六圈，而是 Guru 的所有的训示。
Yeah, you have to.Study the books, study Srimad Bhagavatam, and you have to worship the deity, and you have to serve the devotees, there are many instructions.
您需要去朗读圣典不叫瓦坛，阅读书籍，崇拜神像，服务奉献者，有许许多多的项目。
Then you'll get the mercy of the Guru.
您这么去做了，就会得到 Guru 的仁慈了。
OK。
下一个是，还是魏丽，魏丽 ，Guru Maharaj 昨天晚上的一个问题，顶拜 Guru 翻译，顶拜您奉献者联谊，有人提出不荣耀普沙的，可以吗？
She said.
During the association, somebody says, propose that we don't honor Prasad. Is that okay?
No, not okay.
可以。
There must be some prasadam.
必须有，就是必须有 prasadam， 无论是什么种类的。
Even sometimes when Prabhupada began in New York, Prabhupada was alone. Sometimes he would just have one apple. Prabhupada would have one apple. He'd cut the apple into pieces and give everyone a piece of apple.
当时帕巴德在纽约刚开创这个运动的时候，他只身一人，他哪怕是只有一个苹果的话，他会把他苹果切成几半儿，然后分给在场的每一个人。
So the program is not complete without distribution of prasadam.
就没有派发 prasadam 这个环节，那么这个联谊的这活动啊，它就不算是完整的联谊。
Whenever there's a program, after the program, there must be distribution of prasadam.
无论什么时候，只要一旦是要有这个活动的话，一定必须得派发 prasadam。
It may be very simple prasadam, but must be something.
你也许这 prasadam 是非常简单的，但是必须，无论如何，一定要有某种。花样的菩萨的。
下一个问题。
下一个是舒提如何对大师顶拜顾老师们向顾忏悔。我这段时间一直妄想通过自己努力去物质方面折腾，今天聆听您的讲课才发现自己太愚蠢，怎么可以跳过拉克什密对至尊主的奉爱不叹而直接想去拿结果呢？祈请顾荣祝福我，把心意安定下来，专注于奉爱的学习和服务吧。请您赐予我力量，理解、背诵和践行整部《博伽梵歌》吧。
Yes, okay. We give you blessings. May you understand the Bhagavad Gita nicely.
那顾说祝福您，愿祝您很好的理解《博伽梵歌》。
And so you should attend the Bhakti Shastri course, take the Bhakti Shastri class.
您应当就是去参加巴蒂萨什奉爱经典的课程，去聆听课程，去参加这课程聆学习。
Yeah, you have to study.
你要去学习研习。
You want to understand the Bhagavad Gita, you have to study. You have to hear it from a devotee. You have to learn it from somebody who knows it.
您想要理解《博伽梵歌》，就要聆听奉献者的讲课，去向那些了解《博伽梵歌》的奉献者来学习。
Just like you want to understand Srimad Bhagavatam, you have to hear it from a devotee who knows the Srimad Bhagavatam.
正如您想学习圣典《博伽瓦坛》，就要从一位了解、知道圣典《博伽瓦坛》的奉献者的口中来聆听。
So you have to hear regularly from the senior Vaishnavas, and they will help you to understand the message of the scriptures.
所以您要有规律的来聆听，向资深的 Vaishnava 去学习聆听，然后他们会帮助你去理解经典的讯息。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个 Vedavati Devadasi 顶拜 Guru， 感谢您。请问曼昆特的居民是不断增加的吗？感恩您。
增加。
增加 the number of the
increase.
Yeah.
Well, there's an infinite number of people in Vaikuntha.
The Vaikuntha 的居民的数量是无穷无尽的。
Sometimes, but people are coming and going.
但是呢，就是有些来了，又有些走了，离开了。
Some people are coming, leaving Vaikuntha. They're going to preach in the material world.
有些人离开 Vaikuntha 去物质世界传教去了。
And other people are coming back from the material world. They're coming into Vaikuntha.
还有一些是从物质世界回到百昆塔家园，进入到百昆塔星球。
OK， 下一个问题。
下一个，华为这个手机，起诵圣名算祭祀，一个人念诵算不算祭祀呢？在心意里念诵算不算祭祀呢
？Well, it will depend on the quality of your chanting. We don't encourage people to chant in the mind. You shouldn't be chanting in the mind. The louder you chant, the more powerful it becomes.
那么这个算不算祭祀？一个人算不算祭祀，取决于你念诵的品质。不建议在心意里念诵。一个人他念诵的声音越高，他的就是念诵的力量就越大。
So, unless very difficult circumstances, people, maybe you're not allowed to chant, and you can't chant because people around you, so then, okay, you can try to chant in your mind, but our mind is not very stable, so it's very difficult to chant in the mind.
除非呢，你那个处境，您的处境艰难，就是不允许您出声的念诵，高声念诵。否则那么在这种情况下，就是只能在心意里念诵，但是心意念诵呢，心意是特别不稳定的，所以很难。
So best is loud chanting. Yes, one person chanting, that is also yagna. If you do loud chanting, then that is also a sacrifice.
那么如果您是高声就是高声的，你念诵的声音是高声的念诵的话，也是雅给亚，属于祭祀。
OK,
即使是一个人，下一个问题 ,OK, 下一个是他肯继续问 ,Samadhi 是分为非人格的神定和人格神定吗？是 Samadhi 可以分成两种，是一种是人格，一种非人格吗？
Yes, you could say that.
是的，您可以这样说。
For a devotee, devotees are in samadhi because they're always fix their mind on Krishna.
奉献者们，因为他们是心意恒常专注于 Krishna 的。所以这种是奉献者的 samadhi 的境界。
These other people, you say impersonalist samadhi, you know, what are they going to fix their mind on? They cannot fix their mind on Krishna. They fix their mind on simply the oneness of Brahman.
而别的人，那些非奉献者，他们的 samadhi 是什么样的？他们不能专注于 Krishna， 他们会专注于那个。无二无别的饭。
So actually, their samadhi is not very secure, and they can easily fall down from that position.
所以他们的 samadhi 是不是特别安全的地位？他们很容易就能从这种 samadhi 当中堕落下来。
They have not actually understood the real relationship between the super soul and the living entity.
他们没有真正的去理解超灵与生物体二者之间的关系。
So devotee is very careful to understand that he is the servant of the Lord. That samadhi is in service to Krishna. We're fixed in service to Krishna.
奉献者们，他们。非常小心的明白他们是主的仆人，所以奉献者的 samadhi 是对于 Krishna 专注于服务 Krishna。
Samadhi for a devotee is working, not sitting doing nothing, but working for Krishna。
奉献者的 samadhi 神定的境界，他们是为 Krishna 去工作。奉献者的 samadhi 神定不是坐在那里待在一动不动的状态。
下一个问题。
下一个 ，OK，Thank you。下一个 ，Yuvati Sachi。Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. O Lord Srila Prabhupada, in Bhagavad Gita 11:32, the Supreme Personality of God has said, "Time I am, the great destroyer of the world." The question is the form of Kala form of time?One of the aspects of the Paramatma, or does Kala apply equally to Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan, thank you so much for your wonderful class, Hare Krishna. 我的翻译一下，这个 Yuvati Sachi Adidas 就是说 Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受卑微的顶拜，荣耀归舍婆哈的。在《回到梵歌》第十一章十节三十二，至尊人格首神说，我就是时间，是世上最大的毁灭者。问题是Kala 的形体，就时间的形体，是它是不是超灵的一个特征呢？还是说它时间是是平等的，指梵超灵还有薄伽梵？非常感谢您的讲课。
I've never had time described in that way. You say an aspect of the Paramatma.We say Krishna is time. Well, we say Krishna is time. Krishna says time I am. So Krishna is time. And Krishna is also there as the Paramatma. And so, you could say they're related to each other because they're both Krishna. Paramatma is the expansion of Krishna in the heart of living entities. And time is Krishna's manifestation in the material world.So you can say there's similar things, but at the same time they're different.
那就是Krishna 他就是说没听说您就是像您这种的描述方式。Krishna 说我是时间，那么 Krishna 是时间。那么也可以这样说，因为超灵是Krishna 在物质世因为时间是 Krishna 在物质世界的扩展，而超灵又是Krishna 的扩展，他在处在众生的心中，所以他们二者之间呢也有一些相似之处，也可以这样说，因为他们也有一些关系。
Yes, it's all, everything is Krishna. You can say everything is Krishna, but is it an aspect of Paramatma? No, I don't see how it's that time is an aspect of Paramatma.
那么因为一切都是 Krishna, 那到底时间是不是超灵的一个特征呢?
Paramatma is Shirodakashayi Vishnu.Shirodakashayi Vishnu is one of the Purusha avatars.
Paramatma, 超灵，他是 Shirodakashayi Vishnu, 牛奶之乡 Vishnu, 他也是
Purusha avatar.
Yes, 他也是 Purusha avatar, Purusha avatar 化身。
So the Paramatma is like that, but time is an impersonal aspect of Krishna.
时间是 Krishna 的非人格的特征。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says he's the taste in water, and he's the light of the sun and the moon, and he's the sound in ether.So these are all different impersonal aspects or features of Krishna. So time is like that also.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌当中说，我是水之甘味，我是日月的光华，我是以太当中的声音。所以这一些特征是 Krishna 的非人格的特征。所以时间呢，也是像这样的类似的。
So in the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, they are described as being vibhutis. Vibhuti means the opulences of Krishna.
在薄伽梵歌第十章当中就描述了 vibhuti, Krishna 的富裕。
And vibhuti is one of the avatars of Krishna.
Vibhuti 是 Krishna 的其中的一个Avatar, 一个化身。
Krishna comes in these different features, different opulences or features which are present in the material world.
Krishna 以这些的特点，以这样的特征和赋予临在，嗯，他们就遍透物质世界。
Yes. Okay.
Okay. 下一个，哦，华为，一个人的面相是他内心的一个显现吗？
听不懂。
嗯，He's asking, that one's facial feature is also the shows one's mind or one's heart.
The face.
Yeah.
The face is the index of the mind.
The looking.
Yes.
The looking of one's face.
Yeah.So is that the question?
Yes, he's asking whether it's true or not.
Yes, it's true.
嗯，是的，您说的很对。
Just like, you know, somebody's happy, you can tell from their facial expression.
啊，就好像一个人很高兴的时候，他的面色就是快乐的。
Or someone's angry, you can tell from their face.
或者一个人他怒气冲天，你也可以从他脸色上看出来。
Sometimes you can tell a person, oh, they're very unhappy. Something very bad happened in their life. They look very unhappy.
有时候你可以从一个人的闷闷不乐的表情上看出他的生活当中出了事情了。
So we say in English, we say the face is the index of the mind.That everything which is there in the face, it's reflecting what's in the mind.
在英文当中有个谚语，就是说，一个人的脸是他的心意的这样一个索引，就是说，他的脸，他的面容，就是展现了他的内心。
Okay, yeah.
下一个 Pasanta.说顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 您好 ，Chaitanya Charitamrita， Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Lila， Madhya Lila 中说到，主尼加南达为什么把主 Chaitanya 的 Sannyasi 当的弄断了三段？书中说这个消失光意义重大，恳请 Guru 明示。
Okay, because Lord Nityananda knew that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, so he doesn't need to have a danda, he doesn't need to have a stick to show that he's a sannyasi. Lord Chaitanya is transcendental to all these material positions. Sannyasa is a position in the material world, and the danda is a symbol of his position in the material world, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not of the material world, he's transcendental.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 超越了物质世界的任何地位， Sannyasi 托钵僧是属于物质世界的一个地位，而当的就是棍子是他的 Sannyasi 的特征，但是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 不属于这个物质世界，他是超越，他是超然的，超超然然的。
Another point is that when he broke the danda, he broke it into three because he wanted to show that Mahaprabhu is not an Ekadandi Sannyasi, but he's a Tridandi Sannyasi. An Ekadandi Sannyasi is a Mayavadi Sannyasi who carries one stick.But the Tridandi Sannyasi is the Vaishnava Sannyasi. He has three sticks bound together.
之所以这根当的被分成了折成三段，是因为马帕布他不属于这个，他不是一个马瓦的 Sannyasi。马瓦的 Sannyasi 会拿一根棍子一个当的，而Vaishnava Sannyasi 他们的是棍子是三根，顶上是三根。
Tridandi.
所以他们被称为是 Tridandi.
Mayavadis are Ekadandi.
Mayavadi Sannyasi 被称为是 Ekadandi.
Ekadanda.
Ekadanga， 他们的棍子被称为是 Ekadanga， 钢钢的。
Danda means a stick. So one stick is a Mayavadi sannyasi. But three dandi is a Vaishnava sannyasi.
Danda 的那个这个梵文词的意思就是棍杖的意思。Ma 这是 Mayavadi 托钵僧所持的棍杖，而 Vaishnava 的 sannyasi 托钵僧他们是 three danda 三根棍子。这是 Vaishnava 托钵僧拿的手持的棍杖。下一个 ，the next one， 下一个是华为，有业报才活着。如果人都没有业报了，怎么活着呢？我们可以选择安乐死吗？These people said that， we are living。Because we have karma, therefore we are living, we exist. If one doesn't have any karma, how can one live? And can, this first part of the question.
If one doesn't have any karma, how can one live?
Yeah.
Well, if you don't have any karma, then you don't have any karma.
当一个人从事就是全然的纯粹的奉献服务的时候，他就没有任何业报了。
Pure devotee doesn't have any karma because they're fully engaged in the service of Krishna. There's no karma.
纯粹奉献者没有任何业报，因为他们完全的、全然的从事为 Sri Krishna 做服务，所以因此他们是没有任何业报因果的。
Yeah.
This person is asking, 我们可以选择安乐死吗？安乐死 ，Can we choose to die?
How to die?
安乐死 ，Let me check this.
安乐死。
安乐死。安乐死。Peace and.Euthanasia.
Okay. Euthanasia means you have the doctors give you something to die, give you some injection which so that you die. You want to die, right? People want to die. They don't want to stay in the world. Yeah.
Yes.
So she's asking what?
She's asking, can we choose to die in this way?
No. No, this body belongs to Krishna. You have to use the body in Krishna's service.
因为这个躯体是属于 Krishna 的，所以必须利用这个躯体来服务 Krishna.
So.We live by the grace of Krishna, we die by the grace of Krishna. If Krishna wants to kill someone, nobody can save him. And if Krishna wants someone to live, no one can kill him.
We are because of Krishna's mercy alive. We are also because of Krishna's mercy to leave this body and die. When Krishna wants to kill someone, no one can save him. When Krishna wants to kill someone, no one can save him.
So we accept Krishna's plan. We don't make our own plans, when I'm going to live, when I'm going to die.
我们是服从 Krishna 的计划，就是当我们服从 Krishna 计划 ，Krishna 来计划我们什么时候死去离开。
We have to surrender to Krishna.
我们必须得向 Krishna 臣服。
And to Krishna's plan.Also,
我们也要臣服，向 Krishna 的计划臣服。OK， 下一个是仆人。十二，顶拜孤莲花族，顶拜所有奉献者，顶拜您。物质世界都是非人格的吗？生物体都是非人格的吗？ 佛教徒是非人格，是指佛教徒本身，还是指佛教徒崇拜的梵光概念？ There are three parts of the question.
Yeah, first part.
The first part is the
material world is impersonal.
Yeah.
Well, it can be personal also. It's how you see the world. If you're an impersonalist, then you will say the world is impersonal. But if you're a devotee, you will see the world as personal.
物质世界也可以是人格的，就是如果是在一个非人格的人的眼睛里，他就是非人格。但是对于奉献者看到物质世界是人格的。
People are here. So many people are here. So many. How you can say the world is impersonal? There are so many people. Everyone's an individual. Everyone's doing their own thing. Everyone has their own way of life, thinking, talking. You can see so many persons. How can you say the world is impersonal?
这个世界有这么多的人，然后每个人都有自己的生活方式，有自己的个人的想法，他们说话都不一样。他们都是有人格的，怎么能说他们是非人格的呢？
You are a person. You cannot say you're not a person.
您是一个人，不能说您不是人吧？
Yeah, what's the second question?
Second is that living entity living entity is impersonal?
No, living entities are all personal. They're all individual living entities. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, never was there a time when I did not exist, nor you, nor all these kings, nor in the future will any of us ever cease to be.
生物体也都是人，也都是人格的，都是个体的生物。主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》说，过去从未有一时刻你不存在，我所有的降临都不曾存在，将来他们也不会停止存在。
Yes. 第三个，第三部分。
第三个Buddhist, the Buddhist is impersonal. Does that refers to the Buddhists themselves or refer to the Brahman Jyoti they are worshipping?Thank you.
Generally, the Buddhists are not worshipping the Brahma Jyoti. Generally, the Buddhists are voidists. They don't speak about the Brahman, they speak about the void, about the kong. You don't hear the Buddhists talk about the Brahman, they simply speak about the voidness, the nothingness.
一般来说佛教徒他们也不崇拜梵光，他们总是在那里说空虚无，他们不是崇拜梵，他们总是说空虚无。
Okay.
This Huawei continue to ask, 纯粹奉献者没有业报，非人格主义者也没有业报吧？
非人格主义者有业报吗？ You have to see what are they doing. Yes, if they still eat, if they still walk and sleep, and they breathe, then they have karma.
你要看这些非人格主义者做什么。如果他们还在那里吃、进食、行走、睡眠、呼吸，他们还是有业报的。
Because they're not acting for the pleasure of Krishna.
因为他们并不是为了 Krishna 的满足 Krishna 取悦 Krishna 来做这件事儿。
So they still have some karma.
因此他们仍然有某种 karma 业报。
Okay. 还有问题？
下一个，还有，我 Kripana Vatsala Devadasi Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 顶拜所有奉献者，孩子没全素，厨房一直放着啪啪念诵。做的饭可以供奉荣耀吗？Her Kripana Vatsala Mataji child is not completely vegetarian, But in the kitchen, there are also always broadcast Prabhupada's japa chanting. And can I offer the food that I cook in the kitchen and honor this kind of prasadam?
What is she? She's cooking meat at the same time and she's cooking prasadam.
Because the kitchen, maybe the kitchen is also cooking meat because the child is not completely vegetarian. She's not saying in detail, but she's saying that because the child is not completely vegetarian, and in the kitchen that there's always Prabhupada's
chanting,
kirtan, jap, chanting, yes.
But
can I in the kitchen, that if we cook in this kitchen, can I offer the food?
Well, it's not the nicest, it's not the highest standard, but you could do it. But you have to have separate pots and separate knives. You can't use the same knives which cut meat, and you can't use the pots which cook non-vegetarian food. You have to have separate pots, you have to have separate utensils.
那么这个并不是最高的标准，最好的标准，但是也是可以的，但是你必须要把这个就是所有的餐具、刀具。 锅碗瓢盆都分开，就不要用做肉的锅，那个锅和洗菜盆来洗这个素菜。
Okay.
Yeah, Mark, can I ask a question about class?
Yeah.
It said that Hari Priya is Mahalakshmi.
Yes.
But Hari Priya is also one of the name of Radharani.
Hari Priya is one of the names of Radharani. Yeah, could be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. 我问的问题就跟课程说到那个 Mahalakshmi 他也被称为是 Hari Priya. 我记得就 Radharani 有个名字也叫 Hari Priya. 我说是的。
Yeah, well, Mahalakshmi is also an expansion from Radharani, right?
Yeah.
Radharani is the original woman, the original female. Everything, all the consorts, they all come from Srimati Radharani.
Radharani is the original woman. 所有的其他的性女神都是她的扩展。 所有的主的伴侣也都是Shrimati Radharani的扩展。 Prasanta Madhaji wants to ask something.
Yeah.
主Chaitanya为什么允许主Nityananda把棍子弄断并且生气，为此生气？
Well, Lord Chaitanya gave the danda to Lord Nityananda to carry for him. Lord Chaitanya had taken sannyas, and at the time of the sannyas ceremony, they'd given him the danda, the eka danda, to carry.
在主柴丹尼亚他当了托钵僧，所以在这个仪式上，主柴丹尼亚就被授予了一个 ekadanda， 一个托钵僧的棍杖。
Yeah, they were walking, all the way from Mayapur to Jagannath Puri, so they were walking for many days, and so at some point Lord Chaitanya gave the danda to Lord Nityananda to carry for him.
那么就是在这仪式之后呢，他们就从马普一路走，走着要去张那布瑞，然后其中有一天，主差丹尼亚就把他的托钵僧的棍子就交给尼提安南的，让他帮他拿着。
So Lord Nityananda decided that Lord Chaitanya didn't need this danda.
So, Lord Nityananda decided that Lord Chaitanya didn't need this danda.
But Lord Chaitanya wanted it. Lord Chaitanya said, you know, he said, I don't have any possessions. I've given up everything. That was practically my only possession. After taking sannyas, he left home. He'd come out of the home and he just had some few clothes and he had his beads and he had the danda. And so it was one of his very few possessions. So when he asked Lord Nityananda, where's my danda? And then he found Lord Nityananda said, oh, he said, don't you remember we were having kirtan and we were dancing and you jumped up, but you fell down, you landed on the stick and it broke. So I threw it away.
然后主尼天安娜就回答说，哦，你不记得了吗？当你在Kirtan的时候呢，你跳舞的时候，你跃到了半空中，然后当你从空中落到地面的时候，你就踩在了这根棍子上，所以就把它踩折了，所以我把它扔掉了。So
Lord Chaitanya was angry. That was my only possession. You didn't take care of it. He was not pleased.
所以主柴丹尼亚就生气了，他说这是我唯一的财产，但是你没有照顾好的，所以他就不太高兴。So
Lord Chaitanya said, I don't want to go with you to Puri, I'm going to go on my own. So Lord Chaitanya went ahead and he left all the devotees to come behind.
主柴丹尼亚说，哦，我不想跟你们一起走了，我想一个人前行，所以他就 大步的流星的往前走，所有的奉献者都把所有奉献者都落在他的身后了。
Okay, yes.
No more question.
Okay, so then we will stop here. So we thank Guru Mani very much for her kind translation. And we thank all the devotees for their questions.
Thank you, Maharaj. For a wonderful lecture.
Mama Ganshi Soyuda Functionsa, Tiwen, Mama Ganshi Nimanda Chanja, Ling Ting, Wama Jufuni, Wanshit Rui, Chuanjiao, Shunli, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki.
Jai.